You can see there's a stegosaurus right over here. Or I'm sorry, not a stegosaurus, a triceratops. Hopefully he's got no problem with us walking past. Hello everybody, GrayStillPlays, and today I'm looking at a new game to possibly bring to the channel, Empyrion Galactic Survival. Now this is not a new game per se, it is an early access, it's been out for a little bit, but holy cow, what a bunch of additions and changes that this game has gone through, all for the better. The basic idea behind this game, it is a very open, sandboxy world survival exploration space game. If you have looked at any of my No Man's Sky content, I guess I would categorize it vaguely in the same realm. They're both survival style games. This is much more akin to something Minecrafty, perhaps. There is a very, very strong crafting system in this game. For some people, almost too complex, but luckily they have included a part of the game called blueprints, which allows you to essentially build something with just the materials and not have to go through like the 3 billion other processes that you'd have to do to build it. There is a large portion of this game dedicated to environment destruction as well. So if you like burrowing holes into the planet and busting up everything on a planet surface, this is the game for you. Let's go straight into a new game here. I played a little bit of this. I am by no means any kind of expert at all, so we're going to go ahead and do a start on Akua. There are two types of planets here, Akua or Omicron. Omicron is a hard planet, Akua is easy medium. The biggest difference is, on Akua, there is normal oxygen levels, so you don't have to like manage your oxygen levels. It's a lot easier to continue to focus on building and scavenging and everything else. Now, in this game, you don't just sit on a planet and explore it and scavenge it. You can actually build a spaceship or a capital vessel, blast off into space, and go to other planets, which is neat. You can have giant space stations and capital ships. People have created, you know, Star Wars, Millennium Falcons, and all kinds of stuff. It's very cool. Let's go ahead and start right in here with Akua. This is like your procedurally generated seed here. We could do randomized and just have it pick something. I don't really know what the differences are. There we go. Let's do that one. This will be new game two, just because I had started another game to, at the very least, get the feel for how the game works. Find out which plants are edible. Yeah, there's a large, like I said, scavenging portion of this game. You go around picking everything up and destroying everything you can. You get experience for just about all of your hard work as well. So as you can see, you start off in this little life pod here. And I'm just kind of doing a real quick view around my surroundings just to kind of see where we are. We want a water source at the very least. There's one. Let's see if we can kind of get at least somewhat close to it. Oh, this is nice. We're going to go ahead and crash land right on the top of a mountain. Well, I guess better that than anywhere else. There we go. After the lovely soft landing we're treated to, we get out of here. F to access the pod. We're going to go ahead and grab all of this. Now, this is the little escape pod that we've crash landed in. Make sure to get all of your items from this pod because it has a ton of crap, including the projectile pistol, so you actually have a way to protect yourself, a drill, a chainsaw, we'll put that down here. It's got a, should have a filler and flattening weapon. Put this flashlight way down here, I guess. We don't really need these O2 bottles yet. This O2 generator is going to be important. We'll put that there. We're going to have to put that in a water source, and that's why it's best to at least find a water source. Here's the filler and flatten tool. These are your land destruction and creation weapons, I guess I'll call them. The drill allows you to just burrow straight into the ground, and the filler and flatten tool allows you to either build the ground up or kind of like make it level to the position of your feet, which is quite nice. Here's our survival constructor, which is what we're going to use to make the very first few things in the game. Let's go ahead and head toward that water source. I believe it's on the other side of this hillock. There we are. We have no need for our pod anymore, and it will disappear on its own. Just kind of get a brief overlook. Now, the gravity in this game is different than Earth's gravity. You're going to notice if you jump, you kind of float very well, and you can fall a pretty gosh dang good distance without breaking your legs. So in that way, it's a lot different than the long dark. Let's go ahead and sprint here. Now, you're also given a jetpack. Oh, actually, real quick as well, let's go ahead and turn our helmet off. The helmet is the U key. The reason why is because this atmosphere is breathable, and we don't need to be using our oxygen for that. Let's see if there's anything here to pick up. I don't know what all of the plants look like by heart, but there are a lot of plants that you can just kind of like walk over to and grab. F is the key that allows you to pick things up and interact with things for the most part. And remember, everything that you do in this game will get you experience. Ah, we have a forest right next to us as well. Some of the things that we're definitely going to want to do is explore on foot, because we need to find some mineral deposits. Got a nice little sandy region over here. That's interesting. Got about... it's about 10 o'clock right now, it looks like. The sun is going down. That makes me sad, but what can you do? Night in the game is pretty dark. So, all right, let's go ahead and throw down our constructor here. Oh, I'm sorry, we actually have it in our hotbar. When you put things in your hotbar like this, it disappears from your inventory. So if you want a little bit more inventory space, this is what you can do. Let's go ahead and place down our O2 generator as well. You don't need to put your O2 generator like deep in the water. As long as it's like touching the water just barely, it works. So you can see there, it's red there, it's blue. We'll just kind of throw it right there. We can go ahead and hit this, and we should be given a couple of fuel packs. Yeah, we have a couple. We'll throw one in there right now just to turn this thing on. As long as the status is on and it has a source quality, this thing will run. So I'm not worried about it. Looks like we have a little slimy guy over there checking us out, possibly this way. We do have a weapon should we need to use it. It is loaded, so that's nice. Let's go ahead and take a look at this constructor. We're given quite a few items. The very first thing that I would say that you want to do in this game, if you are a brand new player, is press your F2 key. And the reason why is because it'll come up with a library. Now, there's a lot of things that I have here that you will not have if you start the game. If you bought this through Steam, all you have to do is go to the Steam Workshop, and holy cow, people have made a ton of blueprints for this. This is not all the blueprints. These are just the ones that I thought were cool and downloaded. So look at this. There's, you know, spaceships. This is a big factory. I actually want to make this when we get to level 5. Atlantis City. This is a floating city, guys. It is a capital vessel, so it goes into space. But it is the size of a city. Look at how much iron and silicon and stuff it takes. Oh my god. Here is a much more appropriate capital vessel. Just a nice ship there. There's a big habitat. Yep, there it is, the Millennium Falcon. We've got that on there as well. And there is a hover vessel here that we can make at level 3. This little guy right here, it has pretty much everything that we need. You can see you need to be level 3. These are the items that we have to obtain, and I think we almost already have them. The first thing I would obtain is a hover vessel, though, because being able to move around on this world is so good. How much do we need here? We need 150 copper ingots. Now, if you want to like split stacks in half, you right click them and then it'll split the stack in half. You don't have to worry about kind of going over your amount, because usually there's so many resources on the planet, and the resources that you throw into the factory will stay there. So if you go over the 230, this extra 32 pieces of iron will just go on to your next blueprint. So that's quite nice. What else do we need here? Cobalt. We'll throw in some of this. And we need silicon. So let me just make sure. Do we have some silicon? I know we do. There we go. Okay. So we can start the production on this once we reach level 3. Obviously, we're nowhere close to that yet. So the very first thing that we're going to want to do to gain a little bit of experience and such is start exploring. Now, there is a map function. You can press M for a fairly detailed map. It'll show you anything that you've discovered. This is a large lake region we've actually landed near. One of the things that we're going to want to discover straight away is resource deposits, like iron, silicon, all that sort of thing, because you get a nice, nice chunk of experience from mining. You also get experience from like sawing things like trees here. So here, we can go ahead and saw this tree with our chainsaw. good to see that technology hasn't really advanced when it comes to sawing things down. Actually, I'm curious, did we actually get any experience for that? I could have thought that we would. If you look in the lower left-hand corner of the screen, when you pick stuff up, you should get some experience right there. See, 20 XP right next to the little hand for picking that up. We got some cobra leaves over here. We're going to grab all this stuff, actually, while we're walking around. Anything that gives us... Oh, that's a minigun drone. Minigun drones are like little angry robotic protectors on the Earth's surface. They're not really things that you want to mess with unless you have, at the very least, a decent weapon. We have this pistol. A minigun drone, I'm not really that worried about. So if it wants to tango with us, I will tango. They do give some pretty darn good resources, too. I'm not really interested. What do we got here? Epsilon Comm Center. Oh, boy, a comm center right next to us. I don't really want to mess with that right away until I have some better resources and such. Let's go and discover outward away from the drone. The drones are probably just patrolling that comm center. Now, comm centers and other little crashed items. Ooh, magnesium deposit. That's good. Magnesium is great for weapons. Ammunition. And a whole host of other things, but it's good to find. So we have a magnesium deposit. I think I see a couple of other grabbable plants here. Pixie stalks, very rare type of plant from what I understand. We'll go ahead and grab that. You can see there's a stegosaurus right over here. Or I'm sorry, not a stegosaurus, a triceratops. Hopefully he's got no problem with us walking past. Looks like he is a herbivore. Don't mess with me, buddy. We have an alien over here. These aliens with these spears are one of the indigenous creatures to Akua. And they don't appear to be angry. They just kind of let you go on your way, which is nice. So there are some creatures that are much more violent than others. But those ones there do not seem to want to have to kill us. Aloe vera, super important for making bandages and stuff. We're going to want to pick everything that we can up of those. Just kind of take a look around here. Another triceratops. Just keep doing what you're doing, man. I don't want any part of it. Looks like we've got a few more resources over here. Now, you'll notice the stamina bar is not amazing. You can sprint for a little while, and then you're pretty much out. The other thing that I like a little hover vessel for, which is, like I said, the very first thing that I want us to put together, is you can, like, sleep in it and stuff like that. It's nice not having to just sit on the outside of the world. Ah, hot dog plants. Yes, these are actually called hot dog plants. Or corn dog plants. I'm sorry. I'm a liar. Corn dog. They are edible, so if you see them, go ahead and grab them. They last a decently long time. Food in this game is perishable, so eventually, if just left in your inventory, it will disappear, and it will turn into spoiled food. You'll notice there, back at the constructor, if you remember, there's a couple of food items that can be made there if you use it. There's things like salamis, and steaks, and coffee, all kinds of cool stuff. Let's go ahead and start digging right now with this magnesium deposit. We'll gain some experience from it as well. Kind of get centered right over it. And then we just start blasting down into the core of the world. Luckily, we can build our hover vessel anywhere. We don't need to be near our constructor to build it. So I'm not worried about that at all. Oh, yeah. We're going now, man. You know that you're hitting the ore because the... see how everything has like this silver kind of sheen to it? That's where the ore is. You'll know that you're hitting just regular dirt. It'll just be brown. Man, we got ore flying everywhere. That's what I'm talking about. I want all that magnesium. Mm-mm-mm. You can see at the bottom right, we also have 3 reloads of our ammunition for the mining laser. It's not really a laser, it's just kind of a miner. It just kind of blasts into the earth here. And we want to make sure that we get the resources to be able to construct more of this for sure, because, man, that would be terrible running out of the mining fuel and then having to, I don't know what you would do in that instance. You'd have to get the resources somehow, but you can't get them unless you mine them. So we're gonna wanna leave at least a little bit left, because I don't remember off the top of my head what the mining fuel, how you make it, like exactly what it is. It says it's biofuel, so it's probably something like, I'm not really sure what it would be. Like I said, the only way to really find out is to go back to the constructor. Let's keep grabbing all we can, though. Now, every time we get some magnesium, you see right there, we just reached level 3. And that was from just mining. Go ahead and grab all these little kind of cubes of, well, not really cubes at all. Just rocks of magnesium here. Oh, yeah, we're getting all kinds of magnesium. This is awesome. Now that we have that going, we're going to go head over here to our F2 button, remember? That brings us back to the factory. And now we can go ahead and start production, which is what we are going to do immediately. We have these promethium pellets. What I should have done in retrospect is put these into our constructor and started constructing them. I think that all the constructors and everything are actually pick-upable now. I gotta remind myself of that too. That's pretty good because back in the day, once you put something down, you were pretty much screwed. Now if you make a constructor in the wrong area, you can still utilize it. Let's go ahead and eat these corn dogs. And back to what I was saying though, you can see here it says remaining time 24 minutes. So in 24 minutes, we're going to have a brand new hovercraft. Oh yeah, guys, and you're gonna see how good, oh, that is not what I wanted to use at all. And you're gonna see how good that is once we're using it. Let's go ahead and continue to mine as much magnesium as we want. Since we're over here, there's no reason not to kind of mine the living crap out of this place. The world is our oyster, boys. And we're going to drain it for everything it's worth. Which is kind of funny because the poor indigenous species are leaving us alone. We come to their planet and the first thing that we're doing is destroying every valuable resource that they have. Oh, we're terrible people. But man, the XP is fantastic for magnesium. Look at that, 45 XP, 90 XP, another 45 XP, another 90. That is great. We're gonna level up pretty darn fast. Once we get to level 5, we can start moving toward a base as well. Now, I don't want to have you guys sitting here while I'm mining all the time during my gameplay, so there's probably going to be times where I like skip ahead just to show you guys like, hey, I found this resource node, I'm gonna go ahead and mine it, and then I'll mine it and just skip ahead to everything that I've mined. I don't know, that kind of, I would feel like that would be more what you would want to see rather than having me just kind of talking to you guys while I'm doing this, although I do love talking with you guys. So there's nothing wrong with me kind of just telling you how my day was, or you telling me how your day was in the comments, and then me talking about it later in the episode or the next episode. Let's go grab all these magnesiums and head on out of here. I want to find other resource nodes besides this magnesium, especially things like iron and the like, everything in this game. Ah, that is crushed stone right there. You saw those little, not really spheres, but I guess kind of just chunks, I'll call them, that were different from the magnesium chunks. Those were crushed rock. We need those as well. So we have burrowed ourselves pretty far down, but that's not a big deal. Luckily, with the drill, we can go ahead and blast our way on out. You're gonna notice here, you can do quite a bit to the environment in this game. So we are really gonna mess with it by digging deep and getting back up to the planet surface. A lot of people like destructible environments, and if you are a fan, I think we should go ahead and turn our jetpack on. We can do that by pressing the J button and then just holding down space. There we go. If you like destructible environments, this is probably the game for you. Look at what we did to this place. We made just a straight up wormhole here in one side of the ground and then to the other side. Let's go ahead and check our map just so I can figure out exactly where we are. Okay, the comm center is over there. Our base is over there. Let us make a slight left here and go this way. I think that'll bring us to an area that we haven't really been to. Yeah, we haven't really gone in this direction. Let's do that. Let's go ahead and explore this way. See what's around. Get my gun ready just in case anyone wants to mess with us. Don't have time to deal with people intent on slaughtering crash landers of the planet. Right there, we got a little raptor kind of hanging around. I don't think he should mess with us too much. What do we have here? Did we already pick that plant? Kind of looks like we did. open plains all up in here. Ooh, is that aloe vera? Oh, yeah. Oh, aloe vera, come to me, my brethren. I need you. More fiber, too. Fiber is good. Makes a lot of textile-like things. More corn dogs, more aloe vera. Excuse me, Triceratops. I don't want any of your ire. More crowbar leaves, too. Some of these things are, like, very medicinal in what they do. More sugar cane. Man, we're finding all kinds of stuff in the forest. Is this a giant mushroom? It is. Alien Plasma ZR1. That sounds important. I will go ahead and grab that all day. Nice little tree over here. Oh, what are these? Ah, more pixie stalks. It's a very open kind of world, though. You can see there is plenty to see in this place and plenty to grab for our uses. What I really want to find, though, is a nice, like, iron deposit somewhere. That would be fantastic. Come on, iron deposit. Now, like I had mentioned, though, walking is the slowest and worst way to go around this planet's surface. We definitely are going to want that hover vehicle, and we will have it soon. I don't think I'm going to make you guys, you know, wait for it in the next episode. This episode is probably getting ready to call it a day. But I will get us a nice hover vehicle ready more than likely. I don't know, I might explore a little bit. Ooh, more alien plasma. Let's go and grab that. 20 XP just for grabbing all these different items. Well worth it. All of this stuff is crafting resources. So you always want to grab it all. If we go into our inventory, which oddly enough is mapped to the tab key, not the I key, you can see that it will stack for the most part. Let's go and start moving some of this crap over here. Go ahead and move our bottled water over here, our O2. Remember, this is just a little extra inventory area. No reason not to use it. What else do we want to move over here? We'll move this work light over here, I guess. I don't know. Either that or maybe the med kit. We'll probably use the med kit more than the work light. There we go. Now we have some extra area to work with. We can eat our corn dog right away. There we are. Open up some of the area. See what we've got going on here. That's our survival constructor. Let's turn a little bit more this way and see if we can find anything in particular over this hillside, this mountainside. Now, I believe we came up this way, but you need to be about 500 meters, if I remember correctly, from any kind of resource before it will register. But there's not much at the top of mountains. I mean, like, no enemies or anything. So you can usually go to the top of mountains and not be messed with, which is nice. Of course, it seems like I'm not able to Skyrim over these mountains anyway, unfortunately. There we go, moving a little bit better. But out of all those different items, you guys can go ahead if you want and go to the Steam area and look at all of those different blueprints. If you see something neat that you want me to try and build, feel free to go ahead and tell me. I'll give it a shot. Like I said, I'm not the best at the game, but I at the very least know how to find resources and mine the living crap out of them. Go ahead and bound up this hillside here. And, you know, the great thing about the blueprints is I'm not super creative. Like, I was never a Minecraft player, so to speak. So when it comes to making these amazing structures and cities and bases and kind of all that stuff, I'm not really very good at it. But if you guys have any suggestions, I am more than willing to learn and get better. Just because it's one of my weaknesses does not mean that I'm not afraid at improving in some way, at the very least attempting to try to improve. I can't guarantee anything. I'm gonna go way at the top of this. Now, different resources. Oh, we see a little planet right over there, or maybe a moon. Different resources can be found on mountainsides. There's nothing to say that you have to be on, like, level ground to find them. So I'm really hoping that we find something else going on here pretty soon. There's another minigun drone. That's interesting. If there's a minigun drone just wandering over there, I would believe that there's probably some sort of outpost or something to be seen. Let's check our map real quick just to find out exactly where we are. Okay, pretty much due south right now of our landing area that we had landed in. Well, not really the landing area, but the area that I had put our survival constructor in. It's kind of bound down here. Not sure how steep, I'm not sure exactly how far you can fall before you start taking damage. I can't say I've ever taken damage from a fall. Or at least not enough to make me realize. Let's go ahead and give it a shot. Nope, still just fine. No issues. Ah, copper deposit. That's nice. So there's a copper deposit right by the minigun drone. Fantastic. Couldn't be in a worse place. Looks like we've got a raptor over here as well. All right, so we've done a little bit of exploring. We've got a hover vessel on the way. And I've at least kind of told you guys a little bit about the game if you've never tried it. Let me know what you're thinking so far. I'm always a big fan of these survival exploration style games. Where did you pop from? Friggin' raptor just popping out of nowhere. Let me get my gun ready in case you don't like me hanging around near you. Grab these hot dogs as well. Folks, I hope you're enjoying it. Other than that, until the next time, stay foxy and much love.